everyone, and welcome back to another of our MATLAB tutorial videos. In this video tutorial, I'm going to talk about how we can use MATLAB to handle different types of file formats. Now, MATLAB can read and write into various file formats like Excel, JPEG, PNG, TXT, etc. Now, to make our life easier with the file handling, MathWorks has provided us with different inbuilt functions that can be used to do the same. So let's get started. I'm going to start with imaged file formats. And suppose you have to import an image in your MATLAB file and store that image values or the pixel values of data in a variable matrix, anything. So to do that, make sure that whatever image that you're working on is in your directory that you're working on. Right now I'm working under the directory MATLAB helper, and I have that image in my directory. So to import that image, I'm going to use import data command, and that can be used to import or read that image. And let's say we'll be storing the value of that image in the matrix I. Specify the name of the file that you want to read and hit enter. You can see in the workspace that MATLAB has read that image in the variable I that we just initialized. So if you have to see what image that you've read, you can use the command imshow, type that and hit enter. That is the image that I just read. Instead of using import data, you can also use the command imread or function imread and specify the name of the file that you want to read with the format, the file format. Right now it's JPG, and you can see in the answer the MATLAB has read that file. And to see that file, I'm just going to write this and you'll be able to see that file. So that's how you can read an image in MATLAB. You can do it with any type of data format, like be it JPEG, PNG, TIFF, anything. You can just use these two commands to read that file, and you can show that file on the MATLAB screen. Apart from this, as I said before, MATLAB can read and write into any type of file formats. So let's create a text file wherein we'll write a matrix that we'll generate in MATLAB. So let's get started. First, I'll initialize x, that will go from 1 to 5. And I'll create y, that will include x, and it will generate random variables with one row and 5 columns. So that will be our y, and that is the matrix that we'll be printing in our text file. You can see it. Now, since you want to write into a text file, first you'll have to name that file and open it in the format that you're writing it. So to do that, I'm going to use fopen function. Specify, since you've not created a file before, you can do it by just giving the name of the text file, and you can write w, that will represent that you'll be writing into that file. So that is how you open the file, and you can see in the directory that text.txt file has been generated. Now, since you'll be writing the matrix y in your file, you can use the command fprintf and specify the file id, the format of the data that is going to be printed. In our case, it's %d, %f. And you'll write the name of the matrix that you'll be printing in the file. So that will print the data in your text file. And once you're done with that, if you'll have to close the file, provide the name of the file. That is it. Your text file has been generated. You've written a text file using MATLAB. Let's see what you've just written. That is the matrix Y, and that was just printed in your text file. So that's how you write a file. Let's say you want to read a file, and for a second just forget that you just created a text file. Imagine or suppose you already have a text file that you want to read in your directory. So in order to read a file, you'll have to first open that file. And how you do that is similar to the way you open a file while writing it. So I'm going to specify the file ID as fopen. That will open my file, the name of the file that I want to open, and since I'll be reading it, I'll represent it by writing R. Now my file is open for reading that file. Now to read that file, just like we specified the data type format, while printing the values, I'll have to specify the format spec while I'll be reading it. So in our case, it is %D%F. And since since the file that has been read will be stored in some matrix, you'll have to initialize the size of that matrix. So I'll do that by writing this. Let's say is to an infinity. Suppose we don't know the number of columns that will be read through that file, so we'll write infinity. And then to scan that file or scan the data from that file, we'll use the command is scanf. Specify the name of that file, the file ID, format spec, and the size of the file. So that was, that will scan everything into the matrix A. I'm sorry, I missed an equal to sign in the first statement. So now you can see in the workspace that an A variable or an A matrix has been generated with some data in it, and that is the data that was read from the text file. Once you're done with that, you'll have to close the file by specifying the file ID, and that will be it for reading the file. Let's see what values are being stored in the matrix A that you just read from a text file. So it's the same as Y that was written in the text file. Similarly, you can also read a Excel file using MATLAB, and the command that is used to do that is xls read, specify the file name. In my case, I'll be using elev.xlsx, and that file is already present in my directory. That's why I'll be using that file. And once that is done, I'll be storing it in the matrix M. And this is the data, and now let's see what has been read into the matrix M. Is the same data again. So this is how you read an Excel file in MATLAB. Similarly, for writing an Excel file, we can use the command xls write, specify the name of the file that you want to write the data into. It will obviously be an xlsx file, and print, let's say we want to print A in that Excel file. A is the matrix that we just read from a text file, and we'll be writing that same data into an Excel file. So once that is done, you'll be able to see an output.xlsx file was generated in your workspace. It's the same file that we initialized here, and let's see what has been printed in that file. That is the data that was just printed. It is the matrix A. This concludes my video for file handling using MATLAB. If you have any queries, please feel free to post it under the comment section and we will try to answer them. Also, don't forget to leave your suggestions for different topics you want us to make videos on, and we'll try to make it happen. If you've enjoyed the video, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button or subscribe if you want to keep yourself updated with our channel. That's all. I'll be signing off. Thank you for watching.